Good evening. Welcome to the Andy Pitzer Center for the Jazz Big Bands at UC Davis. Thank you. My name is Otto Lee. I'm the director of the jazz bands here. And there's going to be two groups playing for you. We're going to have a number of different types of tunes. I'm going to try to play a variety of different styles. Some things may be familiar, some things completely unfamiliar, hopefully. But we hope you enjoy the performance. We're going to begin with a tune by Steve Weist that is inspired by the great drummer Art Blakey, right? And this one is called Art Appreciation. Thank you. thank you very much. That was Gate C13 by Doug Beavers, the trombonist Doug Beavers. That was a tough tune. That's a tough tune, different style than what we're typically used to playing, but I try not to make it too easy on them. They're in school, so they should be learning. On that one, you heard from Matthew on the tenor sax and from Nick on the trombone. Yeah. This next tune comes from the library of Gordon Goodwin. It's completely different than the last one we played. Features some saxophone players playing doubles, which is another thing that I love to do. I think that all saxophonists in jazz bands should have the opportunity to double, mostly because I was forced to double when I was in school, so I like to just pay that forward. But this one's gonna feature Cindy has a solo on the soprano saxophone, and Alex has a solo on the trumpet. And this is The Quiet Corner by Gordon Goodwin. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That was Here's That Rainy Day, and that one featured our lead alto, Cindy, again. She sounded wonderful, didn't she? Okay, we have one more tune left in this band that we're going to take a brief pause, and then we'll be back with another band. So don't go anywhere. I'm counting. I've been counting, so if I see anyone leave, I'll find you. Right. We have one more. This one's going to feature a number of people with very brief solos. This is a tune that was made famous back in the big band era, way back before my time. This is an arrangement that was recorded by the famous trumpeter Harry James. We have our very own Jake taking on that role of Harry James. But this last tune is entitled Flying Home. We hope you enjoy it. Please stick around. We have more music, more fun stuff. Thank you for coming out.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Again, we're going to take a quick pause, and then we'll be back with the second band, and we'll have more music for you. Thank you. Okay, back as promised. All right, this is the second of our two big bands at UC Davis. We're gonna be playing a completely different set. That would be weird if we played the exact same set. We're gonna start with a tune by the great composer-arranger, Sammy Nestico, who arranged for a lot of people, but for the most famously, I think, the Basie Big Band. And I think this is a tune that comes from that library. This is called A Switch in Time. It's gonna feature Nick on trombone, Jay on the alto saxophone, and Grace has bravely volunteered to solo today because we had a person that could not be here with us today because of sickness. So, this tune, Switch in Time, will feature those fantastic soloists, and then we'll continue with the Clare Fischer composition titled Thiers, Thiers. So this is Switch in Time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. The next tune is a composition by the legendary saxophonist from the bebop era, the father of bebop, if you would, Charlie Parker. The next tune is Donna Lee, but this is a strange arrangement by Bill Holman that utilizes a level of dissonance that most of us are not really accustomed to. So I do ask you to brace yourself. The things you hear are on purpose. Right? It may not sound that way, but it is on purpose. Yeah, this is a very challenging tune. This is another one of those tunes, like in the last band, where some of the saxophonists are playing some doubles. You've seen some doubles already in this group. Yeah, they were not immune to that my desire to have the saxophonist doubling, and they stepped up to the challenge. A lot of these players have never, you know, played clarinet or flute before, so you know, like I'm very proud of the work that we were able to do to get even this amount of music ready in 10 weeks, right? Yeah, so let's play it, Donna Lee. Now that I've primed you and your expectations are such, we'll see how you feel about it. Donna Lee. Thank you. Donna Lee, how about it? Thank you, thank you. Okay, we have two more for you before we let you go. Both are equally entertaining, I will say that. The next piece we're gonna play, we've played another piece from the same album that this one comes from. I think maybe that was my first year here. So I'm excited to be able to play another one of these pieces. It's very, very unique. I haven't heard anything else that sounds like it other than this collection of pieces. So this next one is called Rhetoric Machine by Nathan Parker Smith.
Thank you.
different, right? Yeah, if you couldn't tell, that entire album, that collection of music is inspired by metal, right? So it's a metal big band, which is like the craziest thing I've ever heard. Like, you know, if you had trouble bobbing your head and keeping with, yeah, me too, right? That's what happens when things aren't in four. But yeah, they did a great job. That's an incredibly difficult piece of music, and they tackled it. My only direction to them the entire semester on that piece was count. Just count, please. Count. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. All right, just count. This is our last tune. One more. Thank you for sticking around. Thank you for hanging out and enjoying some music with us. We have enjoyed playing for you. I enjoy playing for you. I don't know about them. I think they look like they're having a good time. See? This last tune, we kind of picked last minute. You know, this entire quarter, we've been reading a lot of charts. I think reading music is a great skill to develop and have, and it's not always the easiest thing to do, especially on the chart like the last one. It's hard to just kind of read and get it together, but this chart we read and, you know, it was kind of happening the first time, and we read it maybe a couple weeks ago, and so we decided to put it on the concert for you. We're gonna have a nice random solo selection area where I just get to pick random people that are gonna stand up and play, so they don't even know, right? I get to channel my inner Oprah, right? You get a solo, right? Yeah, this is a little fun tune. We hope you enjoy it. We hope you've enjoyed the evening tonight. I'm very proud to work with both of these groups. You know, this is a dream for me just to be able to get paid to play music and work on music. It's like, man, how lucky am I? But yeah, this is our last tune, Filet of Soul. And it's gonna feature, who knows, maybe everyone, we'll see. Thank you. Thank you for supporting jazz bands at UC Davis. Be on the lookout at our website for the next concerts next quarter. I'm sure we'll have more music to share for you, and we hope you come check it out. Thank you. Have a good night.